Hey guys, it's JLW Games Joe Wendell here playing Theme Park Studio once again, here with our next part to this theme park here that we started in our last video. Would have had a video up a little sooner, but I was having some issues with Theme Park Studio, so I fixed them, I guess. I didn't really do anything, it just started working again. So we'll see how it goes now. So what we're going to do here is continue on, and I want to actually go ahead and add some more rides and stuff. I think that's good. So we'll work with this set of path. I actually want to try and, if I can, get to our first roller coaster as well. Let's go ahead and put a flat ride right here. What do we want to put? Drop tower. Let's use the swings. Also, off screen, I did change the texture of the path and everything. So I think I changed the texture. Or did I change the color? Just the color. So I didn't change the texture. Ignore me. Sorry. Okay. Where do we want the queue line to start and exit? Right there. Yeah, that's good. We'll just change the texture to the same thing so it will blend in there. Alright, let's go ahead and change the that texture of all these. I actually need to change the texture of the path too, because for some reason I can't find... Whoops. So let's go pavement. I like using this one. Use it for all the pathways here. Alright. That way I can change that as well, and it blends in perfectly. Man, that's... only part I don't really like is how it's blinking right there. That's kind of... that kind of sucks. Alright. Now that that's done, I kind of want to add some foliage and stuff in between there, which I think we'll do in the future, because right now we're focusing more on the layout and the rides, and we'll add that stuff later to the park. So what do I want to do? Put some... maybe put a bathroom here or something. Architectural. Let's go ahead and put a bathroom here. Don't want our people to go without going to the bathroom, I guess. Alright. Let's go ahead and place it right there. And we're going to add pathway libraries. No. We want this. No. I am an idiot. There it is. This is what we want. Add the pad square underneath this, and we'll change the texture to match this as well. Might as well connect it with this over here. Let's go ahead and snap this for this situation. Just a little bit bigger so it fits in there nicely. I might have to rotate it a little bit as well, just to match this. So, there's that. Okay, let's rotate this object a little bit to line up. Perfect. And let's texture it real quick. There we go. As much as I hate this blinking like that because they're intersecting, just don't know why they do that. Wish they could fix that. Which, hopefully they will. Or there's a solution to that, that'd be nice. So there's a bathroom. Now, why don't we have a roller coaster in the middle of the park right here. Kind of going over the Ferris wheel. That'd look cool. I'm gonna do that. So let's start on our roller coaster. What do we want over the front? Do we want to be like Cedar Point and put a wing coaster over the front? Or Aero Steel Looper? Or Intamin? Man. I really like I like wing coasters. Let's go wing coaster. I love B&M too, so. Alright, so this takes a substantial amount of space. Let's kind of put it off to the side here and we'll connect it with the pathway later. Alright. So, we're gonna have this going straight up this way. I haven't figured it out yet to make my own custom lift hill. I know I can make it a really steep lift hill if I wanted to. Or we can do the lift 100, of course. Does that look alright? But we're gonna go ahead and go with it. So there's our lift hill. To our roller coaster. Now these drop turns, go back to normal. I'd love to use, I'm one that likes to, I don't know where I was meaning to say something else. I'm wondering how to flip it to the other side, to go to the other side. I have not figured that out yet. Because I have yet to figure out how to get this drop turn to go to the other side. And I've not figured it out yet because, well, it doesn't say. But I like it kind of, should we make it go through the path like this? I think that looks kind of cool. to make it go through the pathway right here. That's a perfect spot. That'd be a perfect spot to put it right there. Yeah, let's go ahead and try that. It looks cool. Okay, I want to try and get out of the pathway. I don't want to be in it too much. Kind of want to make it at least a little bit realistic. Whoops. What did I do there? Need to go straight. Build and start to level it out a little bit. Alright. That looks pretty cool. Nice compact park, which I love the path interaction and the park interaction. It looks really cool. Alright, while we're up here, why don't we create a barrel roll or a twist type here, which I'll create my own. That looks good. Let's go right back down. Start that way and go down. Alright, so I like how this is going so far. What element do we want next? Maybe a cobra roll or a regular loop, corkscrew. You know, B&M's have seem to like the cobra roll. Seems like a very popular B&M element. Let's make it a little smaller. Make sure we'll make it through there. I'm gonna have to change these supports because being a wing coaster, that's gonna hit right through those poles. Which thankfully we can actually change that ourselves, so just a little bit bigger. There we go. Alright. Okay, so we got our lift hill, drop turn into a inline a twist type of element, going into the cobra roll. And now, I don't know where I really want to go towards this. That path there. Maybe we can make a twist through the lift here. Maybe have a little airtime hill. Just a small airtime hill with a lot of speed on it. Go down. And maybe kind of turn. Yeah. Make sure we turn here before we run into that bathroom. There we go. Okay, and at this point we want to level it out so it's not going inside the ground. We add this a little bit bigger. Whoops. Because I don't want it to, the trains to run into the track there, or the supports. Alright, so I like how this layout's going. It's looking pretty good for a B&M coaster. Alright, we got 3 inversions. We need a little bit more than that. So let's level this out. Go straight again. Make that a little smaller. Alright, now let's add a corkscrew. Is there a corkscrew going the other way? Maybe I can do a helix this way. Winged over. What is that? Oh. Alright, these helixes only go down, so a lot of elements they still need to add in this game that they have yet to add. Okay, I'm going to delete that last piece. Have a straight piece to where it's still, I want it to still be sideways here. And going up a little bit. And that'll work. Alright, now we'll do our turn. Turn this way. And go straight. Level out at the same time. Let's go down. And maybe do a corkscrew now. Corkscrew. Alright, this isn't going to be a huge coaster, just a kind of a little basic coaster. So we line this back up with, as best as we can, line it back up with the station. Make that go down a little bit. It's very hard to, one thing I have to say is it's very hard to line this up with the station, and it's one complaint I have about this. So it made it kind of hard to do this. And then when you click finish, it just kind of does whatever. Let's see if I click finish now. It's not going to be a complete straight thing here, which is something I don't really care for. And I can't really change that. Whoops. So, oh man. Let's try and make this a little bit bigger on this bank here. Go back down. And curve. And that looks pretty lined up. We'll see though. Actually, that's perfect. All right, let's add the brake section there. Oh, come on, I didn't want that. You know I didn't want that. I didn't want it to do it on this one. There we go. All right, so we got our new coaster, and this video gotten a little bit longer than I expected, so when you come back, we'll test this sucker out, and we'll be back. So I want to thank you guys for watching this episode of our theme park studio, and come back for the next video and we'll test this roller coaster out and see how it works, and then maybe do some support work on it and stuff to make it look a little bit better. So I'll see you guys then. Goodbye.